it's actually equal to torturing animals. The other issue is that it was that it might have been a mistake that the ruling party didn't exactly understood on what they are voting, and instead of approving, they voted for rejection or the other way around. But the scary fact about it is that the Shita in Poland was catering for major communities in Western Europe, in Belgium, England, Germany, and France. So it's becoming like a becoming European issue actually on this problem. And if we think that Polish community was deprived of kosher meat, then we can say, well, we will survive, we can import. But it has a very deep symbolic meaning, to which it seems that Polish authorities somehow didn't realize that it will have such a bad effect on the image of Poland. When they are trying to improve their attitudes towards Jews and towards history, you know, the big thing is that the construction and preparing for opening of the new Museum of History of Polish Jews in Warsaw, the building is ready, the exhibition is not ready yet, so they're trying to, I don't know when it will be open, but at least this is and Polish government actually contributed a lot of money into that. So they are trying to show that institutionally they are also changing their position. But things like this testify to a different thing. And because of this big export of kosher meat from Poland, it was also a big economic loss for Polish economy. So the question, and the, maybe I would say the thing to thought about, is that when economic issues are suppressed by some ideology, that sends a very disturbing signal, because honestly, you can do whatever you want in the world of politics, but when it comes to money for the country, you should think about it twice or maybe three times. So why to cut this income? So that's in a nutshell. I'm sorry if I was chaotic and skipping and jumping from one subject to another, but I was trying to give you the best comments to the movie that you saw. If there are any questions, I'll be glad to answer.